Hey friends, Eric here from Around 2 at RC, and I've got another plane here I want to show you. Now this is the Carbon Z Yak 54 made by eFlight, and I bought the Bind and Fly model. So I can't really wait to get my hands on this bad boy right here. So let's take it over to the workbench and unbox it. All right, everything that was in the box is now on the table for the Carbon Fiber Z Yak 54, with the exception of the transmitter. Now this came as a Bind and Fly model, and I'll be using my Spectrum DX7 transmitter with this plane. So let's take a look at everything real close. Now first off, this fuselage is huge. I'm really enjoying the looks of it so far. It's got a pilot in it there, and he's massive. We've got a magnetic canopy right here that allows you to put your battery in here. And it shows the 60 amp speed controller right there. Looks like the same one that came with the Habu. That's pretty awesome. And everything about it looks pretty cool. Everything's pre-installed. Remember, this is a Bind and Fly. And like I said before, Parkzone and eFlight, they're really spoiling me with these Bind and Fly models because you can get them up in the air so quick. Now let's take a look at the rest of the stuff that came with the plane. Now, you've got a couple carbon fiber rods here. These are for the support for the main wing and the rear wing. You've got your tail wing right here, your part of your landing gear. Here's the other two sections for your tail wing right here, still in the package. And these wings look really great with the decals on them. The ailerons are already pre-installed on them. And the reason they call it the Carbon Fiber Z is they have carbon fiber support throughout the wing and the body. So it gives it more support, more stability, should handle nicely in those turns and everything. Let's see what else we got here. We have a small parts bag, and here's the battery. It's a 4-cell 14.8 2800 milliamp hour battery with a 30C discharge. Now that's a pretty cool battery right there, and my Habu batteries ought to work fine with this plane, so I've already got a bunch of batteries in reserve just waiting to go. And here's the charger. Now normally I say I don't like the chargers that come with these Bind and Fly models. They're doing better with this one. This one has the alligator clips on the end, so it makes it easier to attach this to a DC power source. You don't have to actually get in your vehicle to plug it into your accessory adapter. You can actually charge it with a portable battery if you like, or an AC to DC power adapter in your home. And it's set up for 3 or 4 cell charging with a different rate up to 3 amps on the charging system. So that's pretty cool. I'm liking that. And of course, you always should read your manual. Yeah. All right, got that out of the way. Now, I'll just build this off camera real quick, and then we'll go to the flying field and give it a test run. So we'll see you at the flying field in just a little bit.
Eric, this is the tower. You are clear for takeoff.
This is the actual maiden flight of the Yak 54, and on this flight I was only supposed to take it up and check trims and do a little pattern flying, but as you can see, it was already dialed in from the get-go, and I just couldn't help myself, so I just started pushing the plane to see what it could do.
Very accurate.
Yeah, that's low rates too.
I've had the plane up for less than a minute, and I'm already wanting to try spin dive, so let's give it a go. Alright, nice spin dive. Okay, now for a quick flyby, and let's buzz Candy the cam gal. Alright, now check out how axial the rolls are. That's awesome. Looking pretty good. Now let's get right into some inverted flying. And now let's get a flyby, fast and inverted. Looking good. Now let's roll it a couple of times while staying inverted.
Okay.
Well, with all the 3D flying that I was doing, I actually forgot this plane could probably do a loop too. Let's check it out. Yep, there it is. The powertrain on this plane is pretty awesome, as you can tell from the vertical climb I'm doing right now. Then I'm going to hover for a few seconds, wing over, and right into a loop. This is the actual first flight, first battery with this plane for me, and I'm really having a blast with it right now. I really don't even want to stop flying, but as you can hear, my timer's going off, so I need to bring it in. Let's go into an inverted spin dive right now, and then we're going to bring it on in.
Well, there you have it. That was the maiden flight of the Carbon Fiber Z Yak 54 made by eFlight. And let me tell you my final thoughts about the plane before we get out of here today. First impressions, blew me away. Fell in love with the plane as soon as I got it up in the air. All the trims were set just perfectly. I didn't have to touch any of them. And just to let you know that I did set the low and high rates up per the manual. Yeah, I read the manual. Imagine that. And I set up the dual rates, the low and the high, per what the manual said. And it dialed it in perfectly. Now, after another two or three flights, I think I might tweak them just a little bit to my preferences. But that's a good starting point for you. So, with that in mind, I really did enjoy flying this plane today, and I hope you did too. And I'd like to hear some input from any of the other Yak 54 flyers out there, and tell me your thoughts about the plane. So that's about it for today. I'm glad you got to see me again, and we'll see you later on the tube.
I have been on it the whole time, and then I lost it. Okay. You got to stay away from the sun, and let me clean this screen. That's nice. I like it.
Yeah, remember when I was in the road the other day and you told me to get out of the way?
Yeah.
Well, get out of the way of the camera.
Listen here, you. I'm glad you got to see me again, and I'll see you later on the tube. Ain't that right? And I'll see you later on the tube. Ain't that right?